Welcome to this liturgy tonight, blessing feminist ministers. Time and again, throughout history, communities have called forth individuals to bless them and do works of love, mercy, and justice. Today, we gather to bless feminist ministers. We are inspired by divine wisdom and image her. We work daily to bring about the kingdom of God, the Holy One, divine wisdom, Sophia. We begin our celebration by acknowledging the land on which we sit. The Piscataway and Anacostan peoples have blessed this land here in Washington, D.C. area for generations. We follow in their footsteps, or dare I say, in the moccasins of the Native peoples who could be called feminist ministers and healers. So type the names of the indigenous peoples of the land where you are in the chat, so we can honor them. We stretch across the United States tonight to Canada and usually Australia. I don't know if the Aussies will be jumping on. So the Native peoples have been a part of the lands on which we sit, and we are grateful. This liturgy celebrates feminist ministers and feminist ministries, and blesses feminist ministers for the work that we do. Think of the feminist ministry that you do. Perhaps it's healing ministry, political ministry, community building ministry, teaching, education, parenting ministry, gender and racial justice ministry, leadership and organizational ministry, every kind of ministry. Have you been blessed for the work that you do? We're here to bless feminist ministers, to bless ourselves, and to reclaim feminist ministries for ourselves, our communities, the church, and society. So in the chat, type your name and describe your ministry just in a phrase. For example, I'm Diane. I create liturgies and counsel the brokenhearted. And just scroll through to look at the feminist ministries that we're involved in, just those of us on the screen tonight. So multiply that time and time again and think of the power of feminist ministry. Our first song tonight, maybe an unusual one, but it is the powerful one that speaks to who we are as women, as feminists in ministry.
I am woman, hear me roar, in numbers too big to ignore. And I know too much to go back and pretend. 'Cause I've heard it all before, and I've been down there on the floor. No one's ever gonna keep me down again. Whoa, yes, I'm wise, but it's wisdom for the pain. Yes, I paid the price, but look how much I gained. It only serves to make me more determined to achieve my final goal. And I come back even stronger, not a novice any longer, 'cause you've deepened the conviction in my soul. Oh,
O divine wisdom, Sophia spirit, womb of life, we are strong, we are invincible. And today we remember feminist ministers, named and unnamed, who throughout time have used their ministry to bring love, mercy, and justice to the world. We call upon these ancestors to help us discover within ourselves your power and the ways we can use it for peace and healing. Miriam, you cared for your brother Moses as his life was in danger and skillfully reunited him with his mother, preventing grief and anguish for one family. You gave hope and lifted the morale of a frightened nation as they sought freedom and a better life. Together, we honor you for your feminist ministry. Eve and Lilith, you reached for knowledge and found that it was good. Together, we honor you.
Honor you for your feminist ministry.
Sarah, Hagar, Rebecca, Rachel, and Leah, you answered the call of divine wisdom and put faith in a covenant with the Holy One, Sophia's spirit. Together,
we honor you for your feminist ministry. Mary, you were a mother who listened, pondered, and gave birth to Jesus, Sophia prophet, and Miriam's child. We honor you for your feminist ministry. Mirabai Andumundai and Queen of Jhansi, you wrote Hindu hymns and devotions, provided spiritual leadership throughout India, and fought fearlessly for India's independence from imperialism. As we pray, we honor you for your feminist ministry. Mahopra Shapardi Gautamai, you nurtured and cared for the child Buddha, led a delegation of Sakyan women to request the ordination of the first Buddhist women, and fought for equality between lay and clergy men and women in the faith. Together, we honor you for your feminist ministry. Mary Magdalene, you were the first to announce Jesus' resurrection, the apostle to the apostles, and the foundation of Women Church. And we pray, we honor you for your feminist ministry.
Phoebe, you presided at a local church. Prisca, you supported yourself as a minister. Junia, you were imprisoned for your beliefs. Tekla, and the other women leaders of the early house church movement, you were called to a discipleship of equals. Together,
We honor you for your feminist ministry.
Fatima, you preserved the words revealed to your father Muhammad and gave the Islamic faith their written holy book, the Quran. And so we pray,
we honor you for your feminist ministry.
Teresa of Avila, Catherine of Siena, Therese of Lisieux, and Hildegard of Bingen, doctors of our church, you challenge the corruption of the institutional church, and we are grateful and pray. We honor you
for your feminist ministry. Saint Mother Theodore Guerin, Saint Mary MacKillop, Saint Joan of Arc, and all excommunicated women, Sor Juana Inez de la Cruz, Carmel McEnroy, Myra Poole, Yvonne Guevara, and all silenced women, and Teresa Maxis Dutchman, Louise Lear, Joan Chittister, Mary Daly, Teresa Kane, and other dangerous visionaries like us, we pray. We honor you for your feminist ministry. Feminist ministers and theologians, you speak out against oppression in all its forms, and we pray, we honor you for your feminist ministries. I invite you now to type in the chat the names of other feminist ministers who have come to mind. And we ask that you take a few moments to do that.
What a litany of our ancestors. Wow. Wow. And so many more keep coming to us. You can keep typing them in the chat as you think about them. And for now, we turn to the foundation of all of our ministries, which is Isaiah, the reading from Isaiah.
A reading from Isaiah. The spirit of divine wisdom, Sophia, is upon me, for she has anointed me. God has sent me to bring good news to those who are poor, to heal broken hearts, to proclaim release to those held captive, and liberation to those in prison, to announce a year of favor from divine wisdom and the day of God's vindication, to comfort all who mourn, to provide for those who grieve in Zion, to give them a wreath of flowers instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of tears, a cloak of praise instead of despair. They will be known as trees of integrity, planted by divine wisdom to display God's glory. They will restore the ancient ruins and rebuild sites long devastated. They will repair the ruined cities, neglected for generations. Strangers will tend their flocks. Foreigners will till their fields and dress your vineyards. But you will be called priests of divine wisdom and ministers of our God. You will enjoy the richness of nations and inherit their wealth. Because your shame was double, insults and abuses were your lot. Now you will receive a double share in your land, and everlasting joy will be yours. For I, divine wisdom, love justice. I hate robbery and sin. So I will faithfully compensate you, and I will make an everlasting covenant with you. Your descendants will be renowned among the nations, and your offspring among the people. All who see you will acknowledge that you are a people blessed by divine wisdom.
We've proclaimed the ministries of our feminist ancestors and what names we have named in the chat and in our hearts. And we've been challenged by the words of Isaiah. So now we ask ourselves, how do I exercise feminist ministry? A good way to look around the screen and see that my guess is everyone here is staying in the struggle in some way and keeping on. And thank you for that. I want to move us into affirming our feminist ministries because that is how we're staying in the struggle.
Let us call forth the many ministries among us. When you hear your ministry called, wave your hand for an affirmation. You may wave your hand as many times as you wish. Let us call forth those among us who are in political ministries, peace workers, those who work with immigrants, those who work against trafficking and domestic violence, grassroots organizers, lobbyists, housing advocates, those who hold political office, marchers and protesters, those who vote. We pray. Wisdom's power and compassion
to you
in your ministry. Let us call forth those among us who are in community building ministries, those who sustain and nurture religious communities, those who raise future generations of feminists, those who work with women and children in shelters, those who work in partnership with women across religious traditions. Let us extend our hands to those waving and say, I do this for all of us. Wisdom's
power
and compassion
to you
and your ministry.
Let us call for those among us who are in ministries of feminist theologies, parents, mentors, writers, religious educators, and artists, those in media and communication, teachers, and feminist theologians. Let us extend our heart to those waving and say, together,
Wisdom's power
and compassion
to you and your ministry.
Let us call for those among us who are in healing ministers, prayers, preachers, eco-feminists, liturgy planners, Eucharistic celebrants, dancers, musicians, spiritual companions, counselors, those who use massage, Reiki, or healing arts. Let us extend our hands to those waving and say, together, wisdom's power and compassion
to you
in your ministry.
Let
us call for those among us who work in gender and racial justice ministries, those who work for racial justice, reproductive justice, LGBTQIA+ justice, healing for those with HIV, AIDS, and eradication of heterosexualism, ageism, sexism, and all isms. Let us extend our hands to those waving and say, together, wisdom, power,
and compassion to you in your ministry.
Let us call forth those among us who are in leadership and organizational ministries, community leaders, fundraisers, pastors, bishops, rabbis, imams, directors of justice organizations, elected officers, team leaders. Let us extend our hands to those waving and say together, wisdom,
power, and compassion to you in our ministry.
Let us call forth the many feminist ministries of the discipleship of equals. Let us extend our hands to bless one another together. Wisdom,
power, and compassion to you in your ministry.
Hold your bowl of oil. Oil is the sacramental symbol that strengthens us for feminist ministry. Oil represents the Holy Spirit, Divine Wisdom Sophia, who calls us to act justly, love tenderly, and walk humbly. Let's bless this oil by chanting together. And let me say that this oil chant was used at one of the women church gatherings. And if you let yourself lean into just singing Om for a little bit, I invite you to connect with the power of Om, the primordial sound of the universe. It's the sound that reverberates in the entire cosmos and every cell of our body. So let's hum the Om together in our own spaces. Om. And send it forth to those who need healing. The anointing of those who are called has a long and deep symbolism, going well back into the Hebrew scriptures. Those who are anointed are cleansed, healed, strengthened, and sealed as healers. So let us anoint one another with this holy oil. And yes, we can, even in our own space. Put some oil on your hands and bless yourself with it and receive a blessing from your community and from those of us who are here on the screen. May the blessing of God go before you. May her grace and peace abound. May her spirit live within you. May her love wrap you round. May her blessing remain with you always. May you walk on holy ground.
Thank you, Daniel. And now let us take that blessing and anointing and put our prayers into action. And here are some possible ways. You can write a note or send an email to a feminist minister and thank her for her work. You can get involved in a feminist ministry. Many ideas were just listed for us, perhaps one named here, and share your gifts. You can also acknowledge, like we have done today, that you yourself are a feminist minister.
Sorry. In going forth, sending forth feminist ministers. Feminist ministers, take your gifts to the cities, streets, and county roads of every neighborhood. Let us go forth in all directions of the universe to bless and to embrace, to forgive and to heal, to welcome and to sanctify. Let us go forth to the unhoused and to the hospitable, to the hungry and to the full, to the thirsty and to the justice seekers. Let us go forth to the elderly and to those who seek wisdom, to the exiled and to those who understand freedom, to the hopeless and to those who seize visions.
Let us go forth to religious leaders who are unable to perceive the needs of their people, to government officials who ignore the cries of the poor, to world leaders who reject the movements for peace. Let us go forth to people of every race and place, to the young and to the old of every neighborhood, to the next generations and to their children of every nation. Let us go forth in the name of divine wisdom, Sophia Spirit, the God of love and liberation, the goddess of power and justice. Let us go forth to proclaim feminist ministries. Let us go forth to heal the world.
I am standing on the shoulders of the ones who came before me. I am stronger for their courage. I am wiser for their words. I am lifted by their longing for a fair and brighter future. I am grateful for their vision, for their toiling on this earth. We are standing on the shoulders of the ones who came before us. They are saints and they are humans. They are angels, they are friends. We can see beyond the struggles and the troubles and the challenge, when we know that by our efforts things will be better in the end. They lift me higher than I could ever fly, carrying my burdens away. I imagine our world if they hadn't tried. We wouldn't be here celebrating today. I am standing on the shoulders of the ones who came before me. I am honored by their passion for our liberty.
I will stand a little taller, I will work a little longer, and my shoulders will be there to hold the ones who follow me.
So don't you just want to put in all the women in theology and ministry that we named in the chat? And going forward from where it stopped to all the women in history who have made a difference. Thank you for tonight. Thank you for everyone who had a part in tonight's liturgy and did it so well. Thank you, Annalie, always. Thank you, Pamela, for splitting yourself between us and your class and for your part in making this ritual possible. I hope that tonight has empowered you to believe in yourself, to do the work that you have been called to do in this world. We're starting a new intern with us in about a week and a half. And one of the first things that we always say, interns on the screen, what's your passion? And just know that if you don't do what you are called to do, the world is less. And it won't be done. The world will not receive the gifts that you have. That's what tonight is about. And so let us go forth filled with the power of all the women who've gone before us.